Alright, I have returned to Let's Play Baldur's Gate 3 after a 2 hour give or take nap that I laid down to have. I stopped the recording, went and had a snack, and then tried to get some sleep because, thanks to my mouth lately, I haven't been getting the rest that I require. So I have to try to take the naps when I can, when my mouth is calm enough. And thankfully, I managed to get a couple hours of sleep. So my energy has been slightly refreshed. I have a drink with me. I'm ready to go to play more. And yeah, I think that's, I think everything will be good. Can I swim? No? Water is considered a chasm. I agree. There's a giant, disgusting squid arm thing here. Look at the little suction cups, like, ew. Okay. Well, anyways, so one thing that I was, because I was talking to a couple different friends about the game in between now and the last episode, and one of the things that I was told was this. You can hold down Alt to see things you can interact with. It doesn't show you everything, I think, if I remember correctly, but it will help to tell me some of the stuff that I can interact with, and you can even click on the text to do that instead, so it's kind of Diablo-ish esque. But we've got a mangled fisher here. Poor man was just fishing. Coins. Take that. And I've still got to get used to all of these different icons in the UI and stuff, so I'm sure for people that are accustomed to the game already, it's probably a pain in the ass to watch me do this, but it is what I'm attempting to do. Okay, the scimitar does have finesse, because for my melee weapon, I want to focus on a weapon that uses finesse. And I do have a dagger, which I believe I was told does finesse. Yeah, finesse and thrown, so you can actually throw the weapon like a throwing knife, I guess. The axe probably isn't. Yeah, the axe can be thrown, though, but it is not finesse. But the scimitar is, so I should be good with that right now. I don't have to really worry about moving it. And I don't... It doesn't look like weapons are different, necessarily. Like, where are they? No. 4 to 9 damage. It looks like the scimitar is just a scimitar. There's not, like, substats that are different on each individual scimitar where I have to look at each one, but maybe that'll change as we play. I don't know. And I did find armor as well, but since I don't have my other party members at the moment, I don't have my other inventories to look at. Dark mind. A humanoid brain. I'm not sure what you can do with this right now, but we have two of them, so there's that. That's pretty cool, I guess. Oh, Shadowheart. There she is. Unconscious and, like, dead, maybe. No, she's unconscious. She's not dead. And there's that weird thing she was holding earlier. No, I'm not gonna reach for the artifact. I'm just gonna try to wake her. I am interested in knowing what it is, but I don't want to get myself in trouble.
You're alive. I'm alive. How is this possible?
I was hoping you might know that. Doesn't matter. We made it.
True. Seems like we're the lucky ones, judging by all the corpses strewn about.
Corpses.
I remember the ship. I remember falling. The nothing.
That's called death, m'lady. Do you have any idea? Why am I getting messages now that... Are you fucking kidding me? Oh my god. I don't know what the hell is going on here, aside from the message that I got. For like the past 2 hours now, there has been somebody in the back parking lot blasting music in their car, but there's like a speaker? Like they're talking through a speaker like there's a celebration or something? Like, you know, like a concert speaker, like a stage where someone would be talking through a microphone, except it's a back parking lot in a relatively low-end apartment building. What the fuck, dude? It's loud as shit, damn it. Anyways, whatever. I'm back now, and I'm going to pretend that the real world doesn't exist for as long as I possibly can. Anyways, do you have any idea where we are?
No. I don't recognize this place. But anything's an improvement on where we just came from. First things first. We need supplies, shelter, and most of all, a healer.
Healer.
We might have escaped, but we still have these little monsters in our heads.
Oh, she means not healing just, you know, flesh wounds, but healing the worm in our brain. Yeah, that's probably important to get rid of that. What is that sound? Is that the ship? Is that the Nautilus? The Nautiloid or whatever it's called? To our Gith friend. I wouldn't call our Gith a friend, but...
We need each other. And we both know what's at stake. Can't think of better company.
Okay. Well, alright. Let's get moving then.
One thing. Just before we go. I wanted to thank you again. For freeing me. It would have been all too easy for you to run right past my pod. But you didn't. I'll remember that.
Shadowheart will remember that. Shadowheart, I mean. I wonder what happens if you leave her. Does she just die? Maybe? I don't know. Maybe you can kill her? Maybe she shows up. Well, actually, no, I wonder, because the ship would probably crash either way. So perhaps the dialogue would be different because we didn't save her. And so she still got out, just not thanks to us. That's an interesting idea. Now, does she still have our inventory? She does. Okay, she's got everything in there. I'll need to, like, figure out what all this stuff means and start sorting through it. You can see the inventories of all party members in the party view. Tab to open party view. Oh my god, that's so much more useful. Okay, now I can see everything right on the screen, right up front. I don't know how many party members you can have. We know that you can have at least 3. So, that's presumably what we will be doing. Whoops. I don't mean to be playing her.
Never a dull moment.
Never a dull moment.
Something the matter.
Oh, well, we got lots of options here. Well, let's see if we can learn about that artifact.
There's no story. None that you're entitled to hear, anyway. Just forget you ever saw it.
I mean, she's not wrong. It's not technically our business. But at the same time, the fact that she's really trying to hide it makes my curiosity go through the roof, so...
We haven't gone all that far yet. What are you referring to, exactly?
Almost dying, like 7 times.
Must I? Thinking about it won't help. We know what to do, so let's do it. Find a way to rid ourselves of these things. We've no solid leads right now, though. We'd best get hunting. If you discover anything that might help us, I'm all ears.
I like her voice a lot. Very soothing sounding. And I also must say that, well, I don't know yet because I haven't gotten to, like, all the side content. Like, you know, side quests and stuff. But I really do appreciate finally getting to play an RPG that's, you know, voiced in some way. And not saying that non-voiced RPGs aren't enjoyable. That's just all I've played of RPGs recently are ones that are walls and walls of text dialogue and not a single word actually vocally spoken, which can get a bit exhausting after a while. What will you do if we actually manage to remove the tadpoles?
I suppose we'd go our separate ways. Not a slight on your company, of course.
No reason for us to not stay together if we get on well. Oh, what the hell, am I already starting to fuck somebody?
Home. Baldur's Gate.
Roll credits.
There's someone waiting for me there. Someone I have to reach. As soon as possible.
We're digging a little bit too deep here. Seems personal. I won't pry, yeah.
Thank you. And you're right. It's a delicate matter. Not something for light conversation.
Well, I mean, if our relationship grows as we travel together, I don't see why we can't stick with one another. Man, I look terrifying. That one blue eye over here, the demonic eye is just... it's kind of scary looking in this angle.
I must admit, you've been a surprise, and not an unpleasant one. Kindred spirits are few and far between for me. Besides, you saved my life aboard the Nautiloid.
Nautiloid.
How can I do anything but sing your praises?
Oh, I see. This is where I can... Whenever we camp... I guess this is how companions work. They go back to, like, a... I don't know, maybe a town or a camp or something. So I can get rid of them and also pick them up again if I want to. I want to talk about all that's happened to us. Is that what... Isn't that what we just talked about?
What's on your mind?
Yeah, that's what we just talked about. Should get to know each other a little more. I mean, we technically
did. Must we? No harm in a little mystery, don't you think?
I like a little mystery in somebody. You don't want to talk about yourself? I don't want to pry if she doesn't want to talk. We have to rely on each other. Easier if we knew each other as well. That is true. Trust, growing the trust. Just looking to make conversation. I'll say we're just looking to make conversation right now.
Conversation shouldn't be made. It should be grown. Let the seeds sprout in their own time.
All right, fine, whatever. We don't have to make small talk. Jeez, man. At least she's not a penis about it. Like, at least she's just, if you're not comfortable, I won't press you.
Thank you. I'm sure we'll get along perfectly well.
She's very nice so far, mostly. She's clearly hiding something with that artifact, but... All right, leave. Yeah. I'm not going to separate right now. Whoops, that's not the right button. Yeah, see how I'm holding Alt right now? And nothing's showing up on my screen, but I can interact with this clamshell. So it's only certain things, like maybe chests and people, perhaps, like this, like bodies. I say people, but I mean corpses in general. So, like, what's in this clam over here? Oh, it just is a clam. It just is. Clamshell. A quick shake sends this mollusk's imperfect pearl rattling around within its hinged shell. I'm sure that's probably important for something. The thing is, though, is that shell wasn't necessarily easy to see, and there's no indication that it's even something you can interact with, so the possibility of me missing so much stuff is very high. And I don't think... It doesn't look like I can angle the camera up and down. Like, I can do this. I can move it around, but I can't get it to... Those are very unpleasant noises. When I zoom in, I can see ahead of me. So perhaps I guess that's the camera angling I need to be using here. We've got a barrel, a wooden barrel. It's seems to be lootable. It's got a little chest symbol. Ah, rope. A length of strong, hand-braided rope. It's probably useful. Oh, now it tells me. Okay, so the game actually tells me that you can highlight nearby items, making it easier. That would have been useful to know on the Nautiloid. Just in case there was something there I might have missed, but... Okay, now we've got branching pathways, and I don't exactly have an indicated direction. There is some sort of structure that way. So, and I want to try to search as much as I possibly can while we're out and about. It's just looking around at the terrain here, see if there's anything I can... Oh, look, see? There's something, like, just hidden right here. There's, like, an herb. Mergrass? It's wet. Recipe unlocked. Suspension of mergrass. Press H to view. This must be an alchemy. Suspension? Mergrass. Oh my god, I don't know what any of this is. I need three, though, I guess, in order to make... Suspension of mergrass. Touching a little of the substance to your lips, you begin to hear muffled pulses of sound. Huh. Interesting. Okay, well then now I really need to pay attention for stuff. A dead fisher. He's got some coins on him. He doesn't need those. There's an intellect devourer. It's got nothing on it. There's a bucket of fish. I can interact with these. Oh, that's disgusting. Camp supplies? Huh? I wonder if you can cook these. I'm not sure exactly what food would do for you. Camp supplies. Be sure to collect food and drink as you find it in the world. You'll need these supplies to restore your health and resources when taking a long rest. Yes, you do. I'm sure you do. I still hear the music, just... Bitch. Shanties for the bitch queen.
Fresh water. There must be a settlement somewhere nearby.
Oh no, it's this crap where you have to read the shanty. That doesn't tell me what it sounds like. And the bitch queen stays the storm. Wave mother, wave mother. Without the bitch queen's will. Till the bitch queen brings the waves. Okay, interesting. Got some gold, water, and apples. So apples is food. So food is for camp. And water, I guess, might be an ingredient in something. Perhaps for more alchemy. Can I go in the water? Oh, I can. What? I can go in the water a little bit. Doesn't look like there's anything I can really do out here. And is there anything in the water that's important? Okay, I can't go any further. No, they just let me walk up the... Whatchamacallit here. Mangled fish. That's even worse than just a dead fisherman. Perfumed leather, huh? You can read books and notes you have picked up in your inventory. Press I to open inventory. Dude, can you guys hear that music? I don't know if you guys can hear that, but it's loud. I mean, that's not even just, like, the neighbor being loud as shit. This is in a parking lot, past the trees, behind the house. Read. Sigh, I love you. There, I said it. And if you meet me tomorrow, I'll say it again, and again, and keep on saying it till we're old and gray. So let's do it. Let's go to Baldur's Gate. I thought they were gonna have sex. I know it's risky, but so is staying here. The last few months have been hard, but they're always a little easier when you're there. Leave your boat and meet me at the hill overlooking the old bridge, bringing whatever you can carry. We'll make do without the rest. Don't be late. Love, Anna. Well, unfortunately, it looks like the man has died. The woman might still be alive, but that's probably an unfortunate circumstance. And apparently that's the second time we've heard about Baldur's Gate. I didn't know Baldur's Gate was a thing, like a place. I guess it's important in some way. There's another backpack here. Got now rufflesome blaggart hat. I'll take it.
Anything of use?
Well, that's what we're going to find out. Some water. Another fish and a bottle. Oh, that's that mysterious liquid stuff. Is this stuff stacking in my inventory, by the way? Yes. Okay. Oh, I gotta keep an eye on my actual inventory space. I'll sell those weapons and stuff when I get the chance. First opportunity I have to sell it, I will, probably. Money. What are these gold marks? Intellect Devourer. Oh, they're bodies. Oh no, they're alive! Oh no, the little guys are alive. Okay, then what's over here then? There's a door. It doesn't really look like you interact with the door. I was purposefully avoiding going that way because I thought that that's where I might need to go, but it looks like maybe we want to go back into the wreckage of the ship. So I'm going to check what's over here. Doesn't look like the door's even open. We got some more barrels, another dead fisher. Boy, there's a lot of fishers out here. They were just minding their own business, doing, you know, making a living. Gold. Thieves' tools. Oh, thieves' tools! That's how you pick locks, right? I think it said. Enable you to open locks based on the sleight of hand check. I don't have that, so I think. Never mind. The tools break. Maybe I can find a party member that can handle that kind of stuff. Son of a bitch. That fucking music, dude. I want to go out fucking back and deck whoever the hell is doing that in the face. These intellect devourers don't seem to have anything lootable on them. There's some more mergrass. Waypoints. You've discovered a waypoint. You'll be able to teleport to this location by selecting it on your map. What? Overgrown ruins, an ancient door. Oh god, the door. Fish, golden bottle. Alright, sounds useful. So we've got an ancient sigil circle. I can't seem to... Oh, there's a belladonna here. Take that. That's another... new thing. Need to check in here. Oh, it actually shows you too if you've looted something. The little chest icon is open now. That's super useful. Oh, the door is... Oh, no. Lockpick. I don't think this works, does it? What if I... Skills? It would be in here, right? Somewhere. Sleight of hand, plus 3. Okay. Out of the two of us, my sleight of hand is better, but I doubt plus 3 is all that fucking good. And then the music started up again. It stopped. Like, when I said something about being pissed off about it, the music stopped and then it came back. Because I'm a son of a bitch, dude. Like, you know, maybe if it was a holiday, but it's 22:27 right now. It's almost midnight, and they're blasting music in the back parking lot. That just feels, not so courteous for everyone else that is trying to enjoy their night. Well, let's see, lockpick. Oh god, you need a 20? No! I would have to get so lucky! And it would use my tools, wouldn't it? Oh no, it's just saying that... Wait, what do the tools... What? What does the times one mean? Or dexterity. Plus 3 to dexterity checks. Agility, reflexes, and balance. Total 3. What if I selected this? Add bonus. Oh, I don't know what the times one means. I guess that just means I have one. It doesn't say that it'll consume it, does it? Oh, it says tools break on an unsuccessful attempt. So I've got one on hand, and it will break if I fail this. Dexterity is... I get a plus 3? So this is a dexterity thing because it's a sleight of hand. So I automatically get a bonus of 3. That's what the sleight... Okay, that's what it said in my character sheet, too. That's not good, because that would mean I'd have to get at least a 17, right? If I'm not misunderstanding this, in order to roll a high enough number to get the 20. What is an add bonus? Guidance. The target gains a plus 1d4 bonus to ability checks. 10 turns. What? This is divination cantrip, which is from Shadowheart, but I don't... Well, I mean, do I try it? Or do I want to try and look and see if... You know what? Before we try this, I'm going to search around a little bit, because we can apparently teleport here, just in case, like, if we come across Mrs. Smallnose, maybe she has a higher stat for sleight of hand. I doubt she does, but... just in case. And what is this ancient sigil circle here? Map. General tutorial. This is the map of your surroundings. You can view quest locations and place custom markers. You can also teleport to waypoints you have discovered by selecting them. Okay, well, we've got our quests here. We've got overgrown ruins. Waypoints. Okay, so I can just... Oh, the sigil is the teleport point. Is that... It is. Oh, okay, so that's what that is. Okay, well then I'll just remember that this ancient door, which I guess is probably like some dungeon we can't exactly access right now. Alright. Ducted comet. Yeah, they are kind of gross. They're really gross, actually. They're fire. A dagger? Don't think that's... Now, there's fire here. Okay, it didn't burn me. I don't think I got too close to it. What the hell? They fight? High ground rules. Positioning is important. Range attacks from above are more likely to hit, while range attacks from below are less often to hit. Okay, well, that makes sense. I didn't know these things fought. I would have killed the bastards on the thing.
Better stay back. One strike could be lethal.
What? What do you mean one strike could be lethal? Don't tell me the brain is going to kill me in one hit. Okay, which one here is gonna attack next? I don't know. Or is there a third one somewhere? There's a third one somewhere? Because this one has different amounts of HP. Where the hell's the other one? Oh, Jesus, I don't fucking know. Alright, let me see what we can do about this. There's gotta be some... Do we have anything that we can do that's not just a... Well, do we want to bleed it? For two turns? Is that really that important? This one's got lower health, so I probably should focus down at least one of them. Well, I am a little bit worried here, but... Possibly throw your enemy off balance. It's a bonus action, and I think it's free, so why not? It didn't do it, but it did do it a little bit of I guess I should have just done it to this. The only reason I didn't choose to try to kill the first one was because I thought I could knock the other one over. Okay. Oh, I can move away, but they might... They'll whack me up my ass, won't they? I really don't want to do that, so I'm going to... Oh, shoot, one of them's gonna take a turn, though. Or no, yeah, where is this other one? He's up there. Stupid bastard. Okay, well, first of all... Yeah, we'll get rid of one of them for right now, but I also want to use... She's got, like, this... This here. It's a level 1 spell slot. Increase its armor class by 2. It says until long rest. What, I just get the buff forever? Okay, well, until long rest, I guess. Where do I see, though, like, because these spell slots... Where do I see... Like, is there a limitation how many times I can use them? Oh, right here. Level 1 spell. See how there's, like, two little squares? I'm guessing that maybe when I use one of these spells... Do I have Guiding Bolt? The next attack roll against this target has advantage. Or we can heal a wound. Or we can inflict wounds. Okay, Disguise Self. Shield of Faith. Oh, shoot. Well, first of all, let's get rid of this guy, unless I miss. No, I didn't. Okay, and I leveled up, apparently, too. Well, there's only one way to learn how these mechanics work, so... Whoops. Oh, yeah. You. Shield of Faith. Or did that... No, yeah, right here it is. Shield of Faith. Okay, so it lasts until long rest. So I receive just 2 bonus in armor, I guess. Which hopefully just means there's a lower likelihood of getting raped, perhaps. Oh, they actually dropped something. Intellect of our cerebellum. Oh, shit. Dude, the fucker would turn to attack her, wouldn't it? Wouldn't it? Okay, Shadowheart is, like, going to die. Is this where I need to start learning how to use potions? 90%. Oh, God, it's got 9 HP. Shoot an enemy in the thigh... Possibly. Okay, no. Slash at your target's vital points. That's lacerate. Okay. Oh, fuck it. I'll just have to try it and see how this goes. A disadvantage. I guess that's because... Well, because I feel threatened, I guess, because there's somebody standing right up my ass. Oh, he is off balance. What does that even mean, though? Oh, it would do that. It would do that. He's got 1 HP left. Fuck. What does this mean, though? That off-balance thing. How do I... T? Off-balance. The affected entity has disadvantage on strength and dexterity checks, and attack rolls against it have advantage. Okay, I need to see what advantage means again. More makes you more likely to succeed. Okay. All right, now let's try and... Well, what does this do? 4 to 10 healing. Heals and removes burning. We've got 5. I don't know how super these things are, but I might need to use one, though. Because, well, actually... No, I don't have my healing ability. Yeah, but how do I... Like, I don't want to use it on me and then accidentally waste it, you know what I mean? That's exactly what I just did. God damn it! I was right-clicking it! I thought maybe I could throw it at, my other character. Actually, because now the guy with 1 HP is going to... I just wasted that potion. That really sucks. Oh, shit. Well, she's going to end up getting killed, though. I don't want that to happen. Is there anything I can do here? Yes. Oh, what? Okay, I wasn't expecting that. I didn't think he would attack me. I know why he did. It's because of I'm trying to run away from him, but I didn't think he would target her since he was focused on the other girl. Apparently it doesn't matter. As long as you're in the circumference of the shit. Well, now this has put me in a very sticky situation here. What I was gonna try to do is... Okay, well, that missed. That was very lucky. That's what I was trying to do, though. I was gonna get this guy to attack her so that I don't get my ass eaten here. Okay, well then, now I need to use my bonus on healing. 1 and 1. Alright, you are the next one. Advantage. I don't think my attack has... My attack won't even be able to do enough damage to kill it. Is there another option I have in here? We could use Firebolt. Fire, hurl a mote of fire. It does fire damage. Do these guys have resistances? There's no resistances. Is that a spell, though? That's not. It's just one of my normal options here. Oh, I see. See how there's like a little one next to some of these spells? Those must be the ones that actually cost my spell slots. Okay, we got some Final Fantasy 1 shit going on here. Let's do... The next attack roll against this target has advantage. I don't know. I'm trying to find something that could do higher amounts of damage to kill him. Does this pierce through targets? Boy, you need to be like really close. 80%. Oh yes, it worked! Oh, thank Christ. Okay, and now I would like to heal as well again. Now let me try this again. Examine. Ungroup. Like, see, because I can heal, I can use my other spell slot to heal. Oh, she only has 2 potions of healing. Right, our inventories aren't matched here. Oh, jeez, dude. There's so many, like, little things to try to figure out what they mean. Well, I'm pretty sure that my next attack will kill this Intellect Devourer. So, do I want to try to throw a heal at Fubuki here? Or I can just use a potion, because then I'll still have my spell slot, so maybe I'll save it. Okay, let's use the potion accurately now. I think someone told me how to use potions on other party members. Which I thought they said just right-click and throw it at them, but I'm not sure. Not sure what I'm doing there. Perhaps I'll have to check that another time. Okay. Now this would be very awkward if I fail this. 90%. Let's switch to melee. 95%. Okay, chances are better. He could kill me. Oh, okay.
Perhaps our survival isn't such a distant prospect.
Short rest, recover half your hit points and some other resources. Level up. You've gained another experience to level up. Use the arrow on your character's portrait to level up. Okay. Oh, this guy's roasted over here. Roasted brain. Isn't that just tasty? Okay, so I can recover half of my hit points. Aren't I technically already at half hit points? I don't know. Level up. Great, now I gotta see what the fuck this shit means. Oh, that HP increase feels so nice right now. Class features I've unlocked. Is that a spell slot? Yeah, level 1 spell slots unlocked. Gained 2 spells. Gained a passive fighting style. Adopt a particular style of fighting as your specialty. Archery, so ranged weapons get a +2. Defense, I get more armor. Dueling, when you are wielding a melee weapon that is not two-handed or versatile in one hand and no weapon in the other, you deal an additional 2 damage with that weapon. Or two-weapon fighting. When you make an attack with your offhand weapon, you can add your ability modifier to the damage of the attack. Well, for me, I think I will settle with archery for my fighting style. I didn't pick spells. Okay. 2 spells. Oh, here we go. What is this? Wisconsin. Spellcasting ability. Ability that influences your chance to hit with certain spells. Spell save DC. Oh, God, there's so much fucking shit. The higher your spell difficulty class, the harder it is to resist your spells. Spell attack. A bonus to melee and ranged spell attacks. I didn't know there was melee spells. Choose the spells you know from the list below. Spells require spell slots to cast, unless a feature states otherwise. All of these have the little one next to them. Okay, well let's see. We've got animal friendship. Convince a beast to not attack you. Oh, that's could be useful. The creature must have an intelligence of 3 or less. Well, then knowing my luck, this like wrecked my monitor. Knowing my luck, they'll have like intelligence of 4 or something. Condition ends early if you or an ally hurts the target. In higher difficulty modes, the target might become hostile when the spell ends. Okay, we got Cure Wounds, which we've already used that before on the other character. Ensnaring Strike. Your attack summons thorny vines that possibly ensnare your target. That sounds pretty useful. And I can select 2, it says. The cloud blinds and heavily obscures creatures within it. Goodberry. What? Conjure 4 magical berries into you or a companion's inventory. Creatures who eat a berry regain 1-4 hit points. Berries disappear after long rest. So it's just some extra healing items, okay. Hail of Thorns. Weapon damage. +1d10. Piercing. The thorns deal weapon damage to the target and then explode. The explosion deals an additional 1-10 piercing damage to the targets and the surrounding creatures. So it's like a little bit of an AoE. And then there's rave music playing. Like, what the hell, dude? Jesus Christ. Targets still take half damage from the explosion. Okay, so it says that if I miss them, thorns will still explode. So I can still do something. Hunter's Mark. Mark a creature as your quarry to deal an additional 1-6 whenever you hit it with a weapon attack. Doesn't sound too bad either. triple A creature's jumping distance. Okay, I guess jumping will be a thing at some point. Increases a creature's movement speed by 3 meters and speak with animals. Gain the ability to comprehend and communicate with beasts. Huh. Okay, ensnare sounds pretty good, but I also really like the sound of hail of thorns, and I want to be able to talk to beasts. So I think these are the two that I'm going to select for right now. Though a lot of these other ones actually do sound pretty useful. Okay, accept. There we go, that was my level up process. And now we also have to level up Shadow Heart as well. Oh my god, save me. Save me from this. Okay, let's check out Shadow Heart's level. Level 2. Oh, what is this? Channel Divinity Charges. You gain the ability to channel divine energy, starting with two effects. Turn undead and an effect determined... And an effect determined by your domain. Replenished by short or long rest. Actions. Turn undead. Pray to turn all undead that you can... Okay, I'm really confused. What? Pray to turn all undead that can see you. Okay, well, what does turn mean? Oops, I pressed Alt. The affected entity must move away from the creature that turned it. It can't take actions, bonus actions, or reactions other than dash or try to escape an effect that prevents movement. So it's a, oh shit, I'm getting surrounded by the undead, get the fuck away from me ability, I guess. And invoke duplicity. Distract your enemies with an illusion. Okay, maybe the music stopped. Now that we're 4 minutes past 11 at night. Okay. So we've got... This is what I was looking at. Duplicity. Distract your enemies with an illusion. Within 3 meters of the illusion, attack rolls have advantage for you and your allies. Okay. Prepare spells. Prepared spells. You can only cast from a limited selection of spells at a time. Apparently I can get rid of these spells if I want to. And replace them. Protect specifically from aberrations, fleshless elements, fey, fiends, and undead. You or an ally cannot be targeted until you attack or harm a creature. You can still take damage from area spells. Up to 3 creatures receive a minus D or 1d4 penalty to attack rolls and saving throws. Command a creature to flee, move closer, freeze, drop to the ground, or drop its weapon. Sounds kind of useful. Bless up to 3 creatures, they gain a plus 1d4 bonus to attack rolls and saving throws. Oh, I see. Cure Wounds is actually, you have to touch a creature to heal them. As for Healing Word, it can be cast to a creature you can see. Okay. And then this one here. Call forth rain or destroy a water-based surface. What? Is there any in here that I don't want? I mean, that's not too bad. That's... I suppose we could get rid of this. It heals better. Like, it heals more, but you have to be standing next to somebody to use it. And these sound useful. Oh, is that it? Yes. Right, now we're back in shape here. I'm still hurting a little bit, but that's fine. You know, it doesn't matter. Oh, wait, what is this stuff? Mysterious liquid. I don't like that. I wonder if it burns, like if I had a fire spell cast on it. Wait, how do I get up there? What? Oh, just like that, I guess. Potion of Speed, gain an extra action. A +2 bonus to armor class, advantage on dexterity saving throws, and double your movement speed. The condition ends, though, you become lethargic. Ugh, so you want to make sure you use it when you absolutely need to. A skull and a void bulb. Wizard's Bane Oil. Coat your weapon in oil. Its target will receive a -3 penalty to spell attack rolls and spell save DC. What is this DC thing again? A number that must be matched or exceeded to succeed. And disadvantage on saving throws for maintaining. So it's for spell stuff, whatever I target with whatever weapon that I've coated, I guess. But I'm still going to do my best to avoid that purple liquid. I don't want to walk through it and then just fucking die. Oh, yes, a rapier. A silver locket and a walnut. A nut. Okay, so what does this rapier do? Proficiency with this weapon type unlocks those three things, but it's got a higher damage output than the scimitar, I guess. Okay, well that is something I want, and that is something that I will now equip. Equip. Very nice. Okay. What kind of weapons can you use? It looks like shield and, I guess, blunt weaponry, I suppose? I really need to find a place where I can sell stuff so that I don't get too filled up with crap here. There's a guy over here, hold on. Potion of healing, very nice, void bulb. So this way leads outside. There's water and a path that continues up the hillside. So I want to go deeper into the ship and see. Oh, this actually looks like it goes up to that same place. What? Oh, that is pure ASMR sound right there. Oh my god. Like, that's way better than that droning noise, that's for sure. Alright, I have to remember I've got these various throwables that I might be able to try to use. Oh wait, here we go, find familiar. Summon a familiar, a face spirit that takes an animal form of your choosing. Should we do this? I don't exactly know how it works, but I can summon cat. Summon a cat familiar that can meow to distract your enemy. What? That's shit. A crab. Summon a crab familiar that can slow enemies with its crippling pinch. That's interesting. A frog who can spread its bufotoxin, gross, bufotoxin to enemies. A rat with an infectious bite, so it might poison enemies, I suppose. Summon a raven familiar that can blind enemies with its beak. Okay, and then we've got a no, that one's got a poisonous bite, just outright. I mean, obviously a cat seems like the most likely option, but distract enemies, I'm not really sure what that means. Like a rat, an infectious bite. Well, let's try it. What do I do to just... Ha! You have summoned a creature. Click on its portrait to control its actions. Oh my god, I can play as a rat! I can play as a rat? Dude. the hell? What have I got here? I've got dash, leap, a moth that just flew in front of me. What is this here? Dismiss summon. Okay. Hide. Disengage. Retreat safely. Moving won't provoke. Doubles your movement speed. I don't know if I really need to use this right now. I was just seeing how it works. Well, that's fucking weird. Okay. And in it, that is true. There is stuff in the mind. Okay, there's a fast travel point. It looks like it's getting awfully spread out up here, so I'm going down.
What path lies before me?
Multiple of them, actually. There's a room over that way. You there, come here, I need help.
I've got one of those brain things cornered. There, in the grass. You can kill it, can't you? Like you killed the others?
Oh, you were watching, huh? I don't see a weapon on him.
There. Can you see it?
I don't like... That's a pig. Oh no, my perception was shit.
Not a sound. Not if you want to keep that darling neck of yours. And you, keep your distance. No need for this to get messy.
I need her alive. Stow that blade, or I'll show you just how messy things can get.
Promises, promises. But I have other business, I'm afraid. Now, I saw you on the ship, didn't I? Not?
Oh, shit. This guy's kind of being a bit of a winky. I kind of saw it coming a little bit, but... Add a bonus. Okay, I can get... Bless up to 3 creatures, they gain a +1 d4. Bonus to attack rolls and saving throws. So is this an attack roll, I guess, since it's a melee thing? Well, I kind of want... It'll use one of her spell slots. Does she even have an available one, actually? I guess she does. I want to make sure that I pass this. Total bonus 3 to 6. I got a 1. Are you fucking kidding me? What the hell, dude?
You wriggling little.
Your mind twists.
Oh, he's got one too, huh?
Familiar eyes prowling dark, busy streets. You try to hold the memory, but it fades to the worm. The light. The fear.
What was that? What's going on?
Okay, and also it said there I got a 1, so I had a critical failure, which meant that you lose automatically, regardless of whatever the bonuses you get are. So that's why I didn't come up and say +4 or 5 or whatever. Grab his knife and twist. Oh, dude, do I want to try to go again? Oh, here's a dexterity one. We might have... Slip for free while he's distracted. Yeah, I need a 10. Let's get a 7 at least. 15, okay, awesome. So I want this guy off of me. He doesn't seem malicious more than he seems afraid, because he clearly has the parasite as well.
I saw into your mind.
He saw it.
They took you. Just the same as me. And to think, I was ready to decorate the ground with your innards. Apologies.
Okay.
Indeed we are. Please, allow me to introduce myself. My name's Astarion. I was in Baldur's Gate when those beasts snatched me.
There's an awful lot of talk about this Baldur's Gate. Baldurian. Story. Those raised in Baldur's Gate know the city well, for better or worse. Introduce yourself, you're a Baldurian too. I'm sure I am. How, what am I? Oh god, this is some lore stuff that has gone right over my head. Well, since I've got the option...
Is that so? We clearly move in different circles. So, do you know anything about these worms? Turn us into... Of course it'll turn me into a monster. What else did I expect? Although, it hasn't happened yet. If we can find an expert, someone that can control these things, there might still be time. Well, yes, of course. But first things first.
Travel with me. Our odds are better together. I need to get moving. Okay, so it looks like he might be...
You know, I was ready to go this alone. But maybe sticking with the herd isn't such a bad idea. And you seem like a useful person to know. All right. I accept. Lead on.
Journal updated. The Pale Elf. Party line. Your party is shown on the side of your screen. The portraits show your character's health and conditions. Drag the portraits apart to split the party. Split the party? What's the... Why do I want to split the party? There's obviously a reason for that. And now I've got this blue aura around me, which I guess is... Yeah, bless. 6 turns remaining. Oh wait, am I taking turns by walking? Yeah, I am. Okay. Well, it didn't work for me anyways, because I fucking got a 1. Ugh, stupid. That's just my luck. Oh, I hear the pig. Where the hell is it? I'm gonna kill that son of a bitch.
You picked the wrong fight, friend.
I don't think he picked the fight. Oh wait, critical miss? Certain actions are frowned upon by others. Get caught and you might find yourself in a prison cell. Oh, sorry. I didn't mean to kill the pig. Or try to. Oh wait, I can talk to the pig. I just tried to murder the pig, and I'm like, oh yeah, I can talk to pigs. I have the ability to talk to pigs. I also have a rat with me. Okay, well maybe I'll go try to talk to it. Maybe he'll totally be fine, even though, you know, I tried to kill him, right? No, it's okay, it's okay. Come here. Animal handling. Raise your palms to calm the boar. God, I need a 10, though. Oh, okay.
The boar grunts and eyes you warily with its beady eyes.
Don't worry, I won't harm you. Oh god, you can lure it and then attack it.
The boar shuffles its trotters, unsure. Then it dashes away into the wilderness.
Well, I did try to shoot an arrow at it, so... I didn't think talking to it would really have, like, saying, oh, I won't hurt you, would really make much of a difference. I guess he's a bit too frightened. Well, I have to remember now, you can talk to animals with what I chose, so don't immediately try to murder them.
Always
Boss arm. Ashes of boss arm, new stuff. Wait a minute, this looks like something. Oh, we can totally go down here, right? Can't get there. Jump. You can jump to reach difficult areas and surpass obstacles in the world. So that's what jumping is used for, exploration, I guess. What is down here, though? There's
deep grooves in the mud around that rock.
I noticed it rolled for everybody, and Astarion lost. I mean, scuffled rock. Let's can't be added to inventory. Well, can I? What? Combat log. Combat log is the right of your screen. Keeps track of your encounters. Hover over the text to learn more. Exceeded a nature check. Okay, nature check. Can't, well, I'm not trying to, I want to examine. I need to know what's going, hello? Deep grooves in the mud around that rock. Yeah, I see that, but I don't. What is the white? This white line, I'm very confused. Hello? Deep grooves in the mud around the rock. Should I just be looking around the rock? Oh, hold on. This guy's got a level for us. I don't want to get into combat and not have him tip-top shape. So he's a rogue. I kind of expected that. Got cunning, hide, dash, disengage. Except, it looks like it's just, I don't get to, like, do any other further customizing. Speak with animals. Gain the ability. So I needed to use this before talking to that boar. That's probably why I wasn't able to really communicate with it. And does that... Yeah, that does use one of my spell slots. Well, I'll remember that for whatever next animal we come across. This first playthrough is going to be rough, that's for sure. Well, I just get used to pretty much everything. I can't go up any higher. There's something about this rock. Deep grooves in the mud around the rock. So we succeeded a nature check, but it doesn't look like I can do anything with it. Can't throw, too heavy. I wonder if perhaps you can move the rock and there's something underneath it, like a chest or something, but I need like a spell, like levitate to lift the rock, or I need to be strong enough to lift the rock. I wonder if that's why this is a thing for elsewhere. You know what? Can I open the map? Let me see. Journal. Map. It's M. Oops. No, can I? I want to see if I can mark down a marker, and I'll just say mysterious rock or something, just so that I remember it's here, so that we can always come back another time in case I come in if my theory is accurate. God damn, there's bugs floating around now. That is one hell of a jump, girl. And then I kill one bug, and then another flapping bug comes by and starts slipping all over the place. Story of my life right now. How do you take a short rest? Is there any, like, a campfire for that? Oh, more thieves' tools. Nice. Maybe I'll go try that door. Oh, actually, does this guy have any abilities for picking stuff? Hello? What are you doing back here, man? Come on. Jump.
On my way.
No one back home will ever believe this.
Oops, I don't want to do that. Remaining obscured. Sticking to the shadows makes you harder to detect. Your cursor indicates the amount of light. Oh, I see. Okay, so like I can hide in the bushes and stuff. Because I pressed C to crouch down and hide. I actually meant to press C so that I could open up the character sheet, but I want to see. What do you have here? Dark vision, elven weapon training, proficiency with elven weaponry, advantages in the saving throw. Okay, what is the saving throw again? I have to remind myself. Determines whether a target resists a spell. Okay. Opportunity attack. I'm not sure. I forgot what you needed for... Oh, sleight of hand is what you needed. Oh, he's got 7 sleight of hand. So he actually does have a higher stat than my other two characters here. Or other two party members, I guess I should say. And he has a keychain. Lightly rusted. Oh, apparently we all have a keychain. I guess that's from that one key we found earlier. That's why it says one open. Yeah. Okay, so this is so that you don't have to have an inventory with keys randomly spread out. You just put them all on one chain. That's pretty useful.
Should mind my step.
Should mind my step, mate. It's not a knife. This is a knife.
Oh. We got a locked chest here. Well, looks like we'll be testing it out on this, then. Now, that door needed a really high number, but this is just a chest. So it might not be... Alchemy. You can craft your own potions, poisons, and elixirs using alchemy. Gather ingredients to distill into extracts and experiment to brew wondrous solutions. So I must have enough mergrass now to do some alchemist's stuff. There's a boat in here. It's obviously beached itself long ago. Stupid fucking bugs. Oh shit, we're up to an hour and 7 minutes. What the hell? What happened?